once the greatest power on earth, Rome in the 4th century was on the brink of collapse.
Well, put it this way, 20 out of the 22 emperors were assassinated. So it was a terrible topsy-turvy time.
Two co-emperors fought for control, Constantine in Great Britain and Maxentius in Rome. The empire was ravaged by war, poverty, and the persecution of Christians, the bloodiest in history.
When Christians are under duress, they certainly stand up for the faith magnificently with God's help. And the result is quite dramatic.
And Christians in Rome were about to find a champion in Constantine.
There is no question, but he felt, believe it or not, called by God to Christianize the Roman Empire.
Constantine decided the time had come to overthrow Maxentius, the man he called a pagan and a tyrant. The year was 312.
Maxentius is probably the incarnation of everything evil. He was a terrible, terrible emperor. He consulted witches and wizards regularly. He liked to augur the future by various foul means. One included, this is hard to believe, ripping open the bellies of pregnant women and checking out the fetus's livers for clues as to tomorrow. Horrible things.
Constantine's army battled through Europe, defeating the forces of Maxentius. On October 27th, they were poised to invade the city of Rome.
Constantine camped here, 9 miles north of Rome. His army was outnumbered 4-1. So he prayed to God for help. And here in this field, he had a vision that changed the course of history.
Around noon, Constantine looked up at the sky and saw a sign above the sun. The symbol was a cross formed by the Greek letters chi and rho, the first two letters in the name of Christ. Above the sign were the words, "Conquer by this." That night, the strange sign appeared again. Constantine said that in his sleep, the Christ of God appeared to him and instructed him to use the sign as a standard in battle. The next morning, Constantine ordered his soldiers to mark the symbol on their shields, and under the sign of the cross, they headed for Rome. On the other side of the Tiber River, Maxentius sent his troops to meet Constantine, while he stayed behind in Rome.
October 28th marked the 6th anniversary of the reign of Maxentius. To celebrate, he held a day of public games here at the Circus Maximus. But instead of cheering, the crowds turned on him.
They shouted, "Constantine cannot be overcome." So Maxentius fled to the Temple of Apollo. There he searched a collection of pagan prophecies, known as the Sibylline Books, and found a passage that mentioned the date, October 28th. On the same day, the enemy of the Romans should perish. Maxentius thought it prophesied the death of Constantine, so he changed his mind and went to join his troops. But by now, his army was trapped between Constantine and the Tiber River.
The only way back into Rome was across the Milvian Bridge, and here Maxentius fell headfirst into the trap he had set for Constantine.
Maxentius had cut all the bridges into Rome, but at the Milvian, he had built a temporary wooden bridge designed to collapse under the weight of Constantine's army.
Instead, most of his own soldiers were trapped on the bridge. When it collapsed, many of them drowned, and the rest were taken prisoner.
Maxentius himself drowned after jumping into the river. And the next day, Constantine's army entered Rome, parading his head on the point of a spear.
Today, Constantine is known as the first Christian emperor. But was it a real conversion or just a smart political move?
There may have been political benefits for Constantine to do that. I've never understood why he must be only a totally sincere Christian convert or only a calculating politician. There could have been a little of both involved.
As emperor, Constantine remained the head of Rome's pagan priesthood, and his coins bore the image of the Roman sun god, Sol Invictus. He also declared a national day of rest on the Roman day of the sun.
There's no question that Constantine was somewhat of a mixed Christian when it came to controlling the empire. He said, look, we're in a transition period. Please understand that I am emperor of all of the Romans, including the pagan Romans. So give me a little time and we'll phase these out. And he did.
The true extent of Constantine's conversion is debatable, but his influence on Christianity is undeniable.
Within a year, he and his co-emperor issued an edict of toleration. They granted permission for all religions to worship freely and ordered the return of property seized from persecuted Christians.
This was a dramatic, dramatic move. When Constantine was converted, it was at a time when only 10% of the Roman Empire was Christian. At the end of the 300s, 95% of Rome was Christian.
Less than 400 years after the death of Christ, his followers had become the most influential religious group in Rome. And with this sign, Christianity had conquered the Roman Empire.